going to show you a way to do a standing row to work your lats where your torso stays upright instead of being bent over. This is a really good option if you struggle being in that bent over position for one reason or another. You might have core strength, or the back of your legs might not have enough strength to hold that position. Personally for me right now, I actually have a hamstring injury on my left side, and so being in a bent over position for too long is really aggravating for it, not part of the rehab. So whatever the reason, this is a great way to work your lats with an upright torso. What you're gonna wanna do is anchor a band, a resistance band. Ideally, if you wanna keep that upright torso, you would probably mount it about hip height, okay? And that way you won't have to lean over at all to get a good activation on your lats. So probably a door anchor is good for that. They also sell these strips that I've seen. I'm gonna get one and try to show you guys. But then you can kind of mount it wherever you want, but it's like on a wall or something. So positioning here, feet hip width apart, toes pointed forward. Draw your belly button into your spine, shoulders down and back, slight bend in the knee. Nice neutral neck. Hi, I'm Raizel. I create workout tutorials and full-length workouts for women in their over 40s and almost 40s like myself. It's a specific type of exercise. It involves resistance training at home. But even more than that, this is different from what you see online a lot. It's not intense. It's about a much slower paced workout with chill music. If that sounds like something you've always wanted and haven't been able to find, please come on over to my website at inspirefulwomen.com. With the band, you want to step far enough away that you have some tension on the band already, ideally, as long as you can actually do the full range of movement. So from this position, your hands are out in front of your hips a bit, your elbows are soft. And then what you're gonna do is just pull backwards so that your elbows go behind your body and your hands are in line with your hips. Squeeze back and squeeze in. Squeeze in towards your torso with your elbows and then release. Now, if the position that you're in doesn't allow you to pull, like say you can only get to here, ideally then you would wanna come a little closer so that you can get at least in line with your torso. If you can't get behind, that's okay. But ideally you wanna at least be able to try to get in line with your torso here, okay? So let me just do a few for you now. Now, if you'll notice, when I'm doing this, I'm not really bending my arms very much at all. They're basically staying here, and my elbow's not really bending. I'm just pulling my arms back and keeping my arm in the same exact position. So it's the same amount of bend here as here. So for this particular setup, that's probably what will work best. Remember, the muscle that you're trying to feel working is here, this muscle that's on the side of the back. The side back, not the side front, of your back, okay? So when you're doing the movement, try to think about contracting this muscle here to pull the arms back. And then here at the end, again, squeezing the elbows into your torso as well, since that's one of the functions of the lats. And then slowly lower. Yeah, so that's pretty much it for how to do that movement. Thanks for being with me today, ladies. If you enjoy my teaching style, you feel like you're learning useful things, you might want to come on over to my website at inspirefulwomen.com. Over there, what you'll find is additional information, things that teach you the what and the why, like why are we working the muscles we're working, how do we use them in everyday life, common mistakes that we make with movements, how to keep our bodies safe as we do resistance training, as well as full-length workouts with that chill music I was talking about. So I hope to see you over at inspirefulwomen.com.